I don't know whether you all are aware of this, but there are a couple of sequels to The Godfather. The first, The Godfather Part II, also directed by Francis Ford Coppola, is probably the best sequel ever made. 16 years later came Coppola's The Godfather Part III. In 2020, Coppola released a recut version of Part III, the version he and Mario Puzo originally intended, called The Godfather Part III, The Death of Michael Corleone. Both Al Pacino and Diane Keaton supported the changes. It's a very good film. If you haven't seen it, it is well worth your time. The original, The Godfather, earned 10 Oscar nominations, including 3 in the supporting actor category for Al Pacino, James Caan, and Robert Duvall. It won for Best Picture and for its adapted screenplay by Francis Ford Coppola and Mario Puzo, who wrote the novel. Marlon Brando was nominated for Best Actor, and it was widely expected he would win despite competition that included Laurence Olivier, Michael Caine, Peter O'Toole, and Paul Winfield. With the spotlight on him, Brando decided to use the opportunity to make a statement about the industry's mistreatment of Native Americans on film and TV. Brando boycotted the Oscars, and when he won, he sent a proxy to the stage to decline his award, a Native American activist named Shasheen Littlefeather. Unfortunately, her credibility was later undermined when it turned out that she was an actress who fabricated her Native American ancestry, according to her two sisters. Brando went on to earn 2 additional Oscar nominations in his career. We'll have one of those performances, Last Tango in Paris, later tonight. Up next, Brando returns in a memorable parody of his own Godfather character in a crime comedy from 1990, co-starring Matthew Broderick. The Freshman is next on TCM.
Next on TCM, The Freshman, then Last Tango in Paris, and later, The Missouri Breaks. Get to know Brando on TCM Tonight.
Hello, we're here on the world-famous Warner Brothers studio backlot.
It's where